why you were filming. Okay, so I'm Susan Leonard Casmer. I developed ice resin. I'm a jeweler. I have been an artist and a jeweler my whole life. It's like sometimes I think, what am I, you know, what if I want to change? And then I'm like, I don't even know what else I could do, you know? I actually was just invited to do Milan Fashion Week at the end of February with my work. You know, I work with patinas and talisman and silver and resin in all of my work. You know, so this is kind of what you see. You know, I started putting resin in my work 12 years ago. And I started a body of work, you know, that I've just really, with paper, resin paper, creating talisman that way. I found ways to create relics and little reliquaries like this piece here using resin paper. This piece here was made, I did when I was out in Mexico, I did a Day of the Dead workshop. And we gathered things from these gorgeous cemeteries. And, you know, you go down there and you bring beer and you pass them out to the guys at the graves. And the kids get candy. So it's just a different, this Day of the Dead, it's a different feeling that we have, you know, about death. So anyway, I just gathered little flowers and things and put it into a little reliquary with resin paper on top. So for me, I do journals, paper, jewelry, all of this. And it's the same thing to me. I probably could build, I actually did a chair once that had stacked resin paper on it, you know, for the seat. Because to me, it's like I could build a small piece of jewelry to a journal to furniture. It doesn't matter to me, you know, it's just the same thing. This is one of my ballerinas back there that I did. I did a circus troupe that has wearable jewelry. So you can take the jewelry off and wear it. So her skirt is wearable. It's all built of ice resin. So this is the ice resin paper. This is a tissue, and you know, I really, in this book I put together, you can really see how transparent it can be. You can alter these papers in any way you want to by putting inks and putting markers and marks like that. This is a page right out of a book that's super transparent. This is a rice paper here. You know, so really you can flip through here and just see all the different ways to do things. So as far as jewelry goes, some of the cool releases that I have right now are a tissue book that has beautiful talisman and imagery and all of that, that Kelly is so amazing, put together like a lot of my images that I loved and all that. And words, they all fit nicely into a bezel. You know, just some industrial, my work is very industrial. This is what it looks like in the bezel. So this is with the foil. I have foil in my line. I love foil. I always use foil and tints. And this is now the tissue paper. So you can really put these images in that are almost like...
You floated that on top?
I floated this on top. You know, so they're just this beautiful, you know, beautiful layers. These two, this is my foils. It has the tissue images in there. And here's another one here with the tissue, with the images. So that's the image pack that's really nice. In combination, there is a image pack with images. With these, in my work, because I like some transparency, but I like some areas that I want to stay opaque, you know, so I can have that contrast. Like, this piece here, you know, I have a 5 in here, and what you do if with any of these pieces or any work that you have, if you have a photograph, you actually want to seal your work in paper sealant, and this will keep your any imagery opaque, and it won't become transparent. So we're working in two ways. It's a water-based. It dries very quickly. You probably have about 5 minutes, and it dries. And the exciting thing of what I'm doing with this line with ice resin is I am building a jewelry building program is where I'm going. I was just out at the Ranger headquarters, and I put together about 12 film. You know, it was really nice. I think it was one area where I was really lacking when I was on my own. So I put together about 12 film, just really simple, 1-2 minutes, just showing how you attach end caps to the leather, because I have the gorgeous leather. Love the packaging. I've always had a lot of people come up to me and, you know, they're, where do you get your made leather from? And I give it out in class, you know, and I'm like, that's my business, you know? But so now anyway, our leather is here. We'll be, the end caps are coming soon. I know metal well. When there's metal in my work, it's going to be beautiful. I can promise you that. Because I just don't let metal, you know, metal is so important to me as a silversmith. So I don't let metal go into my line unless it's gorgeous. So I think a lot of people know my line that I built called Industrial Chic. You know, and that one I had all, I could, the metal on there was beautiful, I have to say. So this is the leather in the end caps. I have a leather glue. In the jewelry world, you don't really glue metal together. The only place that you really use glue is when you're doing end caps on your piece. So what I love about this leather glue, I've always used E6000 because it's thicker, but this is a non-toxic leather glue that I love. I know, isn't that cool? So, you know, the way that you work this, yeah, I was so excited about this because that, you know, it's like as I try to get my studio cleaner and cleaner, I'm just like, what's this E6000 doing here? And this really holds, it is a longer dry, it's like a 6-hour dry. Oops, I don't have a cap. This is like a 6-hour dry, but when this dries, ooh. Surprise! No, I usually have a pin that I can put in and the end is getting stuck. But see, it's nice and thick. So I pour it right into the cap and then I just put my leather right into it. You know, and then just kind of, I do a lot of them at one time. You know, I'll set a bunch of these down. Just keep it curled. You know, the leather is on a small spool, so it's gonna be curled. But once you put your piece on there and hang it, it will look really nicely, you know, and just, it's just gonna take a little bit of time. It's a natural material. So, you know, these are the bezels. These are my tints in the line. I've got some really beautiful, large grit glitter that I'm so excited about. These are some of the results of it. I like, you know, when I'm putting pieces together. In my work right now, I started doing, this is a look that is really popular, is just really kind of layering pieces together. You know, so I'm putting a couple bezels out here. I've got a reliquary, this is a hollow form with the resin paper, foil in the back, a couple bezels together. And I really started doing a lot more found objects with it too, because I do found objects in my work. Here's the end caps as well. You know, with the end caps, I also can, you know, I'm looking to get fiber in my line. Really, it's in my jewelry class today, I'm gonna be showing making a tassel form. So they're end caps, tassel forms you can do with these end caps. So all of our pieces that we have, you know, it's just a whole building process. Really sturdy jump rings. You know, I know sometimes it's just really hard to find some nice sturdy jump rings. We're holding up pieces. I like large pieces, so we just need some good jump rings to match. I'm going to show you what I do with, this is the smaller resin paper, but I want to show you guys what I do. Oh yeah, thank you, yeah. So this is the luminous layers. This is what this looks like here. This one is wet, I just poured it. That's, I have opals and the glitters and things like that here. And with the tints, what I'm doing with my work is, you can see, since these pieces that I have, you know, I am coming up with simpler, without the nice metal on the side that we can use in combination with these. These bezels here that have some nice metal on the sides, I like to take advantage of this metal. You know, it ends up really being kind of the star of the show, and then it'll be nice to have the combination of simpler ones as well. So as long as I have all this metal, I'm actually using some of my tints, which look gorgeous with these pieces, and just kind of putting some browns on here and, you know, a little bit of these blue colors that you see in metal work. So I'll just lay some tints down right onto my metal work, and, you know, this isn't going to rub off. It's going to be beautiful, and I just, you know, kind of alter it up a little bit, and you get to really work your own metal a little bit more, you know, like this piece here. This has the blue and some of the ancient root on there. So that's really how I start with my pieces, is, you know, making it my own. and then I'll, you know, I'll put foil in the bottom or image in the bottom for my resin. Have you guys, and with ice resin, this is the jeweler's grade, so it's a 6-hour dry. Like I said, you know, everything is going to work its way out. It has buoyancy to it, so I always tack things down to the bottom, which is also the paper sealant. You know, so if I seal a paper, I just tack it down to the bottom. I have studio sheets in the line. When this paper dries, I can just peel it right off of my studio sheet. So these really are useful. If I spill things, I know, you know, I saw Ranger with this in their other lines, and I was like, oh my gosh, I was always using plastic bags, you know, so you can use those too, but these are nice.
If you're using it on paper, do you have to do both sides?
No, so I can actually show you that real quickly, if you'd like. I have some resin mixed. I'm actually going to just cut one of my pieces here, and you don't have to do both sides. I'll mix it right up here, and I'll show you my squeegee that I have. So this is already mixed ice resin. I'm just gonna put a little bit on top like this. I can make it as thick or thin as I want. And then I'm just gonna get in here with my squeegee. I can put some tint on here, you know, to alter it. Now this, it's at first gonna be a little bit cloudy. You don't have to do both sides. The nice thing about this studio sheet is that I can press out all the bubbles from underneath. When I was using my plastic bags, I would peel them up sometimes and have some air bubbles under there. So this, just give it a little bit of time and it will be as clear as this here. Yeah, just needs to sink in. If you don't trust that it's gonna sink through, you can flip it over and do the other side. I have a lot of people in my class that get like, it's been 1 minute and it's still not transparent yet, so I think it's time, you know? So that's kind of that. If I don't want this to be transparent, I can put a paper sealant on it and it will be exactly as it lays right here. You know, so that's kind of the nice thing about that. So with my glitters, I'll just show you real quick with the glitters is, you know, how I'm kind of building. Oh, let me put it inside here too. You know, so with this, I'm gonna actually do one of these druzies like that with the large grit. So here I've colored the side. I'm just gonna put a little bit of resin in the bottom. And I am going to use, a silver would be pretty, but a blue might show up better. Since I have blue on the side, now I have to be careful because I dressed up for you guys and I wanna get all full of resin. This is how I look in my studio.
Quite impressed.
Yeah, I know. High heels, you know. Yeah, a little bright lipstick, of course. So this, you know, usually I'll do this on a card. Any of the overflow you'll be able to just kind of pick up and use again, the overflow. You know, and then I kind of just get in here and make sure it's tacked down. I usually keep it pretty low if I have it exposed. You know, or you can actually just mix it right into your bezel. And I'll show you guys, let me show this one here. This is the opal. Let's see if I can get this open. Anyone have really strong hands? This one, oh, thank you, Milagro. That one doesn't want to open on me.
Really?
Wait, I know, that one's, I'll grab another one.
This isn't on your sheet. The leftover resin, will that just peel off to clean it?
Around. This around the side, yes.
Yeah.
This, once it's dry, once this one is dry, I just peel it off and use it again. So these aren't throwaway. You know, I really, even though I like the idea of, oh my gosh, you have to buy a cup for every mix, you know, I don't really like that we throw so much waste into the environment. So with these cups, spoons, you can wipe
them
out.
Maybe,
you know, these you can either, I can pick it up and wipe it.
See if you can open it.
It's normally not like that.
Like the weakest person.
It's the opal.
Yes, that's Milagro. She did.
Ocean shards.
In teaching classes, there's so many, you know, for me, it's like I usually am a teacher of teachers. And there are so many talented people like Milagro who are around teaching ice resin. So if anyone is looking for a teacher, how about I grab another one? If anyone is looking for a teacher, we have You know, there's a lot of people who do their own work. Look at how easy it is.
Probably resin.
Yeah.
Yes, exactly. It probably is. You know, so this one I mixed up. It's just a small amount. You know, this actually, it doesn't look like anything in the containers.
With the blue one, would you pour more resin over it to seal it? Or?
You know what, with this look, if I like this look, I don't.
Okay, it's sort of chunky.
But you could. You know, I can show you one where you just mix it in. So, you know, and sometimes I'll have a piece that's mixed and I'll just throw glitter in with it. Like, see this one? This has a little bit of glitter in there. That has a little bit of this. This is the fire opal here, which is this one.
I'm sorry, you know, do you put some resin over top of the...
You know, this is just a look that I do that looks like druzy to me.
Okay.
But you can, of course, put resin over the
but
top.
But I mean, like, after you pop the glitter on top of that one right there, the blue?
Yeah, I don't usually,
you
don't? But you could.
But you could. Okay.
You absolutely could. You know, and also you can, you know, these guys, like Milagro, she mixes a lot of stuff in there. I mean, you can certainly put resin over.
Okay.
I kind of like this exposed look because it looks like a druzy. But usually I put resin over, you know, like these. Here's one with a, so actually let me show you guys this one here. What did I do with my
other ones? And stamping on this, once your ice resin paper is done, archival ink, those kinds of things stamp beautifully.
Yes,
on it, right?
Yes. Well, you know what? Do the resin paper if you're using Ranger ink. Pardon?
3 minutes.
Okay, good. Thank you. If you're doing Ranger ink, stamp afterwards. Or, you know, sometimes what I'll do, because in the paper pack too, there's beautiful tissue, but you can just use tissue. So I have these colors. These actually come up transparent. Or translucent. They come up, I didn't believe it. And I did a red one yesterday. I'll have to dig it out, so I'll be here. But they come up translucent, not transparent, you know, with all the inks. So usually, you know, sometimes if there's a lot of ink on the front, I go in and put the resin on the back because the ink will block it. So there's all different, there's some really stiff ones that come up clear, but there certainly are. Rice papers work really well, linen papers, silk papers. If you want to preserve, you know, just a lot of things can be preserved. I'm also looking, you know, I have the putty, as you guys know, with my line, and I do a lot of casting. I love, this is one of my largest cast pieces. This actually, I took a rivet from Mexico. I was in San Miguel, cast a rivet. I put foils behind here and put tints inside, and now it's light enough where I can wear a big, bold piece and feel good about it, you know, and not break my back. So it's kind of, and then this is one here that is cast. You know, this is actually just from a hardware piece. On the bottom is a shell cast, drilled out with foil. There's a bezel with foil on the top that I used as a cap. You know, for me, I love my resin. I like doing metal with it. You know, it makes it richer, it makes it a jewelry piece. So is there any other questions?
Thanks for watching. Be sure to give our video a thumbs up and subscribe to Scrap Time Videos on YouTube to be the first to see all our videos from Creativation.